Hello, this is going to be a little look at a new pen that I've just got. You may recall a little while back I said I was going to try and get one of these pens. It's a nice pen, so it's taken me a little while to get it. Comes in this nice plastic waterproof case, and the reason why I know it's waterproof is because there's a lip that goes around the edge and there's a rubber gasket that goes around just like a Pelican case, which is kind of nice. So you get the case with the foam and everything. You could use that, put gadgets in or whatever, but we're not talking about the case. This is the pen. It's solid titanium. If I can possibly get a view on this, I don't know. It is branded here, but the light reflection makes it a little difficult to see. There you go. So it says RovyVon. I believe it's RovyVon. Yeah. RovyVon. And it's got like a, I don't know, some kind of big cat, possibly a lion, for the logo. It's a bolt action, and it also has a glass breaker, and this is a proper glass breaker. This is built into it. This isn't an aftermarket mod job. This is like a real deal, full shebang, ready to go glass breaker. The bolt action is quite smooth, and the more you use it, the smoother it gets. It's not very highly sprung, so it's very easy on your thumb. It's not quite as loud either as the last bolt action I showed you. It does have a space here where you can put a tritium in. And off the top of my head, I think it's 1.5mm by 6mm if you do want to fit tritium into the pen clip. The clip should be removable because there is a star screw right there. You can see it's a C10, because this is the RovyVon Commander C10 in titanium. This particular finish is natural titanium. They call it natural TI. It's got very good grip, and it's extremely lightweight. I mean, I was shocked at how light this thing is. The other pen that I showed you, it's nice, but it is rather heavy. And it's also a little bit longer than this as well. So this is a bit more EDC size, I think. I mean, especially if you're going to put it in a pocket organizer or in a pocket. This size, it's perfect for writing, not a problem. You've got plenty of length for writing. But it's just the fact that it's slightly more compact and lighter makes it a more desirable option. They do different colours. They do a sand one, they do a black one, and this is the natural titanium one. I'm going to possibly try and get the black one. I don't know. I may do that, and if I do, I shall surely show you a video. So yeah, it unscrews in the same way as the other one does at the bottom. And what you get with it is one of these. You get a Schmidt P900 medium refill, and they're okay. It's a standard kind of ballpoint pen biro kind of refill, but you know me, so I always go for space pen refills by Fisher, because they write in more conditions. It doesn't matter if it's wet, if it's underwater, at funny angles, if you're writing, you're maybe underneath a desk doing networking or something, and you're writing kind of upside down, these refills are great. These are aftermarket. You don't get that with it. You get the Schmidt P900, which is fine. I just prefer space pens. So there you go. I mean, there's not really much to it. It's got excellent grip. So if you do need, if you find yourself in an emergency, either in a car or on a bus, I use the bus, you've got your ceramic ball there for breaking glass, so you would just hold it and strike the glass as hard as you can, and it should shatter the glass, because, you know, rock breaks scissors at the end of the day, and ceramic is better than the glass, so therefore it's able to smash it to pieces. So there you are. I'll put a link in the description below where you could get these from. If you found this video interesting or useful, please hit like and subscribe, and I will see you on the next video. Thank you.